If all goes well, I'll know by Friday. We'll have to put the house on the market right away and move. Portland's a big city. It's a lot larger than we're used to.
If it means we have a normal family life, then we'd move just about anywhere.
Well, I've worked at this for 4 years.
You know, a move like this isn't too uprooting for her. She's still young enough. Besides, actual time with her father would be a good thing. You know, between school and work, you've missed quite a few years.
Em, what you doing?
Do you have school today, Daddy?
Nope. I'm all done with school. You remember when you and Mommy saw me on stage?
You had a funny hat. We're not going to the park today, are we?
No. I'm sorry. What you working on?
What do you think, Daddy? It's you and me and Mommy at the park. See, there you are pushing me on the swing, and we're having a picnic with salad and pop and macaroni and cheese.
We can't go to the park today. Daddy has a job interview in Portland. I'm not going to be driving truck anymore. I'm going to get paid to do my art.
That's us watching the seals. Can we go there instead of the park?
When I get back, if we have time, I'll take you and Mommy to Seattle to the aquarium to see the seals.
You said that before. Can we really go this time? Please, Daddy, please?
Okay. Okay, I'll try.
Promise?
I promise.
But what about the next flight out?
Are all your flights canceled?
Yes.
You don't have any leaving later tonight?
I'm sorry, sir. The only information I have is that all flights are grounded until the weather clears.
But I promised.
Sir?
You have rental cars?
Take the elevator up to the second floor and turn left.
Thank you. Call the real estate agent. I got the job. No, all the flights have been canceled. Rain and sleet. No, I'm renting a car. Well, it'll take me about 6 hours. I've driven in a lot worse. Funny thing is, I thought my driving days were over. No, tell Emily that Daddy loves her. I love you too. Bye. Thank you. Any radio stations in the gorge. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine home to my family. See Emily. Oh, okay, if you're in that much of a hurry, go around. It's okay.
I can't believe it happened to Keith.
Yeah, it's 10 years later. That's just like right here.
I know.
You know, remember him very well. He told me he was so excited to have a 9-to-5 job so he could be here on the weekend.
I love
him. Like Hatch. I don't understand. I can't have this. I can't.
This is what they do. You got Susan and Emily?
What are they going to do now?
I don't know.
Sweetheart, what are you doing?
Getting ready.
Ready for what?
We're meeting Daddy in Seattle, remember? We're gonna see the seals.
Sweetie. Daddy's gone. It's just us now.
No! He promised!
I know he promised you, sweetie. This time he's not coming back.
But this time he really meant it.
No place to be playing. Who are you with?
Oh, there you are, hon. You need to come sit by me now. I'm sorry. I must have dozed off, but she got bored and just started crawling around.
Some people need to keep a better eye on their children.
I'm sorry about taking your gun without asking. Want it back?
Very cute.
diary.
Do you write in it every day, Emily?
Not every day. Almost every day, though. This is my hairbrush.
Now, I can see that.
And these are my pictures. Uh-huh. This is me and Daddy at the carnival. We rode the strawberry. It spun really fast. See, Mommy screamed because it made her sick. This is when Dad got his diploma from school. He is an artist. He used to drive a truck, but he didn't like it. He said his bum always got tired. Mom said she worried too much.
Sweetheart, where was your dad going to meet you?
Seattle, at the aquarium.
You know, this bus is going to Spokane, Emily.
How close is that to the aquarium?
It's a very long way, I'm afraid. I think when we get to Spokane, we better call your mother.
So you describe Emily as a happy, outgoing child.
Yes.
You know what she was wearing? Maybe carrying. Something she was carrying when she left the house. Something we could identify her by.
Oh, a pink suitcase.
Suitcase?
She was probably carrying a small child's pink suitcase.
Yes.
We had a report of a small child matching your description called in from the bus station. The bus was in reach of Spokane and stopped for a few moments at a travel plaza outside of Ritzville. She must have gotten off at that stop.
Well, is she okay?
They're searching the area for her right now. It's out in the middle of nowhere, so she can't go too far.
Are we sure that it's her?
Well, they are talking with a woman right now who was sitting with her at the bus station. They also found a small child suitcase.
Suitcase?
Pink.
Hello, hello? Oh, shoot. Gotta get that thing fixed. Who's back there? Get up here. Get up here. What are you doing in my truck?
I thought you were my daddy.
You're what?
My daddy.
Do I look like your daddy?
I thought you were my daddy coming to get me because the bus left.
Okay. Well, it looks like we just passed Ritzville, so I'm going to go up to the next stop and turn around, and when we get back, we'll get a sheriff and get you home. Waiting for you.
No, he's not.
How do you know that?
Mommy says he's gone.
Well, what happened? Did they get a divorce?
What divorce?
Not a divorce, a divorce. Did your dad move to another house?
No, he had an accident.
An accident? Why don't you get in the back and take a nap? This won't take long. We'll get you home soon, girl. Promise. It's okay. It's just one tire. We'll be okay until we get to Ritzville. I'll make sure they take care of it when we get back there. Okay.
break, Sarah.
Child, what are you doing here?
Santa?
Come. Let's get you cleaned up and something to eat.
Thank you, Kitty.
How about your mother? What must she think about you going away like that?
Where's your kids?
Oh, they've grown and gone away a long time ago.
What about your wife?
She passed away a little over a month ago. These are her kittens. I promised they'd be taken care of.
Passed to where?
She's with God's angels right now. Come, finish up. We must get you to the proper authorities. I'm sure everyone must be worried.
What about my daddy?
I'm sure he's worried too.
Good morning, Mrs. Bailey. Nothing since we talked to the trucker late last night. Now we have officers in the area talking to all the farmers where she was last seen. I'm going to drive up there myself, and I'd take you if you'd like. I can wait in the car outside for you.
Yeah, I'll be just a moment.
She's yours. Just promise to take good care of her.
I will. I promise. How come you don't have a TV?
We never felt the need.
How did your kids watch cartoons?
They found other things to keep them busy.
How come you don't have a car?
This buggy gets me where I need to go.
There's no place for the radio. Oh, Kitty!
Be careful.
Okay, I will.
Oh, look at that. That's something you don't see every day.
But this is the police.
Yes, that is who I meant.
Will they take me to see my daddy?
They'll see that you get home safely.
I had a
visitor at my home last night.
She was right here.
Hey, did you get my jerky? Keep it.
Is this the bus to Seattle?
Oh, I'm sorry. This is a private bus.
What's the matter, sweetheart?
I'm trying to get to my daddy.
He's not on this bus.
My bus left me.
Left you? You're by yourself? Oh, you poor thing. You must be scared to death. Don't just sit there. Can't you see this poor dear scared to death? Are you hungry? Cold? Thirsty? Troy, don't just sit there. Give her something to eat.
Dawn, what are you doing? Her parents might be outside right now looking for her.
My mom is at home.
Were you taking the bus to see your daddy?
Uh-huh. And I was feeding the animals, and the bus was gone.
See? See, my God, we've got to get this girl back to her daddy.
Probably somebody's looking for her. We should go to the police.
What? You too? Can't you see what's going on here? Am I the only one who understands how these things work? This poor girl's parents have probably split. Her dad's in Seattle waiting for his visitation. Her mother, even though it wasn't too smart, put her on the bus alone to see her dad. She steps off, the bus leaves, and that's it.
Well, if that's the case, we probably should call the police.
And break up the family even more? That's just the kind of thing social workers live for. Poor parenting, abandonment. They'll take her away and put her in a foster home somewhere. That's it.
But we already have a home.
And you'd want to put her through that, even though all she wants to do is see her daddy?
We could take her to Seattle ourselves.
What about the gig?
We're going to Seattle tomorrow anyway. We could play the concert and then leave right after, go straight to Seattle. We'd probably even beat her bus there. You know how they have to make all those stops.
Okay, Mrs. I got a plan. How are we gonna find her father?
I'm meeting my daddy at the aquarium.
Well, there you go.
I'll check inside.
Squeeze the Weasel.
Funny name.
It seems to fit.
What's that? Is that the weasel?
You want to hear it? Okay. Dave's the real weasel squeezer, and I'll try.
That's one of our instruments. We play Celtic music, like Irish and Scottish music, like leprechauns.
Like that guy on the Lucky Charms box?
Yeah.
Are you a singer?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a singer.
I bet you have a beautiful voice.
Mommy says I sing just like a nightingale.
A nightingale?
Uh-huh.
Play something so we can hear her sing.
I only know Kelty.
Give her a chord.
The wheels on the bus go round and round.
I got an idea.
All right.
Let's do it our way.
Let's roll.
Kitty on the bus goes meow, 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 meow.
Kitty on the bus goes meow, 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 all through.
you stick close to us while we set up. Before we start playing, I'll get you something to eat.
Can I go play, please?
Well, I guess so, but just for a little bit. And stay where we can see you. Sure you don't want to go to the park? We could get something to eat before we go.
There's no time. Besides, we're finally getting out of this stinking town. Why do you want to go see everyone?
It's not that bad. Besides, you used to like it.
I also used to like peanut butter and pickles, but I've changed my tastes.
Now, don't you go growing old on me. What?
My keys.
Did you leave them on the counter?
No, I think. Did you lock the door yet?
No.
They weren't in there. Now we're gonna be late.
What time did you tell the landlord we'd meet him there?
7:30.
We have plenty of time.
Not if I can't find my keys.
Did you check the ignition?
Did I check the ignition? Who put them there? All right, let's go.
I'm not going to Seattle with you until you take a deep breath. Get us a speeding ticket, and then we'll really be late.
Okay, I'm calm. Can we go now?
Group of people just gave her a ride to Granger.
Oh, is she okay?
Look, the truth of the matter is we haven't located her yet.
Oh.
The people lost her in some kind of festival that's going on in the park. There's a lot of children, so we put an Amber Alert on all the highways. We just probably haven't found her yet.
Who in their right mind would go off with somebody else's child? And why haven't they been arrested? And why haven't you found my child?
She's okay. Emily's a very resourceful little girl.
I know. She gets it from her father.
Every time you look at your watch, you press the gas pedal down further.
I'm not speeding.
Maybe not at the moment. Oh, that's terrible.
What?
That missing child. I couldn't imagine how I'd feel if I were her mother right now.
What? What the? Ugh. Great. Rotten Thing must have crawled in here when we were loading the car.
Isn't it precious?
Don't you go getting any ideas, all right? That thing's going into a shelter as soon as we get to Seattle.
Oh, don't be so heartless. It's just a baby.
I gotta go pee.
Oh, my gosh.
What?
Oh, my gosh. It's that little girl. We're kidnappers.
Okay, calm down, all right? How are we supposed to know she was back there? What are you doing back there?
I gotta go pee.
Well, you heard the girl. She has to use the bathroom.
Sure, why not?
Oh, to meet my dad.
To meet your dad, huh? Does he know that?
Yep.
He does. Does your mom know that?
Yep, I wrote a note.
You wrote a note?
Uh-huh.
Do you think she got it? I saw some signs on the side of the road. Well, I don't think she got it because she's pretty worried about you.
Here, get in the car.
Did you call him?
Who?
The police.
No, Brenda, wait. Look.
Wait, what? Give me the phone.
No. Wait. Just, Brenda, just wait and listen, okay? I thought this through. We told the landlord that we'd be there at 7:30, right? And he said if we didn't show up, that he'd give it to somebody else.
So?
Remember how hard it was to find that place? I mean, It's perfect. It's right by my work, and it's right by your school, and...
Tim, no!
No, Brenda, just wait and listen, okay? Look, we take her to Seattle with us. We sign the lease, and then we take her to the police.
Now we really are kidnappers. All right, make sure the kitty's buckled up, too. We're gonna get going.
Oh, wow, it's raining.
Yeah, it is Seattle, but give it 10 minutes and it'll be sunny again.
Well, that'll take some getting used to.
Yeah. This is an adults-only building.
Oh, that's just our niece. She wanted to see where we were going to live.
And no pets.
Yeah, that's just her kitten.
The lease clearly states no pets.
I know. This is just our niece. She was going to be with us for the day, and we're taking her to her parents right afterwards. No pets, no kids.
Can we go now? What?
My keys. They must be inside.
All right, let's get in the car. What now? All right, buckle up.
Okay.
Stay here and I'll be right back.
All right.
Where did you leave them?
I don't know. They should be. I thought I left them like right here, but they're not here.
Why are you always lose your keys?
What do you
Can't
mean?
Can't you just leave them in your pocket?
Well, I'm sorry. I'm not Mr. Efficient. I'm working on it. Okay.
Oh, I found them.
No, you didn't. Did you?
You get your information up here and call you if you need it.
Okay.
Okay, what's up?
Apparently she's in Seattle.
Seattle.
Right. We had a family that...
Look, you're not going to believe this. We just got a report that she's been seen in Seattle.
Seattle?
How can there be hundreds of people looking everywhere for her? She just sneaks by them every time.
Look, Susan, the best thing you can do in this situation is remain calm. We have our best people on this. You have to be patient. We'll find her. You need to go home. Rest. And then I'll call you as soon as I hear anything.
I'm going.
Home?
Seattle. Are you going to drive me or should I find a ride?
Susan, there's nothing you can do there.
You have children, right?
Son.
What would you do?
I'd be walking the streets of Seattle.
Okay, then are you going to take me or not?
Okay, I'll take you.
Sorry, little one. Didn't mean to scare you. Where's your parents? You're not here alone, are you? This is no place for you. There's crazies around here. Cold and hungry too, aren't you? Well, come on, let's get you out of the cold. Come on, it's okay. We're here to help. No need to be afraid. A lot of my friends live around here. It's a nice place. This is my home.
But this is my car.
I know, but it's still safe. It's nice, it's warm, and there's food in there, too. Unlock the door. And open it for the young lady. Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, you comfy?
Is that your daughter?
She was about your age when that was taken.
Well, where is she?
I lost her and her mother a couple years ago in a car wreck.
Well, then you should go find them.
You're right. I should, shouldn't I?
If you help me find my daddy, he'll help you find your family.
Are you hungry? I've got some great food here, and it is just ready for... What?
What about my kitty?
In the morning, I'll help you find them both, okay? Let's get some rest. Come on. First thing in the morning, we're gonna find your dad.
Thank you.
hungry now. Oh, you will like these. Look at that.
Ooh, baby hot dogs.
Yeah.
Find your dad?
Little girls that look like this around here?
No, I haven't seen her. Sorry.
Okay.
Are you sure he's in there?
He promised.
Now you're gonna have to find him yourself, but I'll be out here waiting, just in case you can't find him, okay? Now, see that group of kids waiting to go in? When they go in, you go in too. Get right behind them. Now.
We don't allow panhandling around here.
Just moving through.
I suggest you do that.
Good luck.
I sure hope you find her.
That's correct.
Why are we here?
What?
Why are we waiting here?
No one's seen her anywhere else. So it's safe to assume that she's still at her last known location.
I'm her mother. I don't assume anything. I want to go to the aquarium.
Susan, we've already discussed this. We have people on the lookout for her there. Don't you find it hard to believe that even a resourceful little girl like Emily can navigate such a big city? Especially unnoticed, with people looking for her?
No. Do you find it hard to believe that she's made it this far?
The aquarium.
Yes, the aquarium.
How did you know I was here?
Well, honey, I've been here all along.
I didn't see you.
Well, sweetheart, I've been kind of hidden. You see, I'm an angel.
An angel? Like the ones on TV?
I'm your guardian angel, Emily.
Where's your wings? Can you fly me to see my daddy? My daddy's not ever coming back, is he?
You'll see your daddy again sometime, but he'll always be with you in your heart.
I don't know what you mean.
Your father's with God now, sweetheart, but he'll always be able to see you. Why, he was with you when you snuck on that truck, and when you were with the band, and even last night when you slept in the car.
I miss my daddy. He promised.
I know, sweetheart. He wants you to have something. Now you close your eyes and just picture your father.
A promise made.
Is a promise kept.
Daddy, Daddy, you're here. I told Mommy you wouldn't leave us.
I'm sorry I had to leave, but we'll be together again.
But we can be together now. We can go home and get Mommy. She'll be so happy that I found you.
Nothing would make me happier. But I can't stay.
Can't you help him stay?
I'll be with you always. Now close your eyes.
No, you'll leave me.
I promise. Close your eyes. See? Can you feel me there? Whenever you want me, whenever you need me, just close your eyes and think of me, and I'll always be there. I promise. Now hold out your hand.
Kitty! Daddy? Daddy?
It's all right, sweetheart. God will take care of your daddy, just like he'll take care of you and your mama. Do you understand? Come along now, Emily. Your mother's waiting.
told you Daddy wouldn't leave us.
My love, you need to accept the fact that your daddy is in heaven.
No, he's not. He's right here.
Oh. I was so worried. I just don't know what I would do if I lost you too. But how did you get here?
I had help from my friends. Frank, we had baby hot dogs, and he has a little girl too. And Clarice.
Clarice?
She's my angel.
You must be Emily. We had a lot of people worried about you.
Mommy, can we go home?
Oh, of course. I'm sure Officer Hall will take us.
Oh, yes. I'd love to hear about Emily's adventure.
Father's love will stand the test of time.